everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time for an Isaac Run here, the Binding of Isaac Invicta Rebirth series. But before we get to that, is your spoiler warning for the previous episode? I'm not going to talk about the episode, so don't watch it. That is your spoiler warning. Don't watch it. We're going to be starting the challenge runs today. These are going to be the viewer-submitted challenge runs along with the self-imposed challenge runs that I was talking about a little bit earlier on this week. And we're going to be starting off with the spacebar override challenge. Basically, what this means is that I cannot use a spacebar item if I have another spacebar item show up. So, for example, since we're going to be playing as Isaac, we start out with a D6. If I walk into the first item room and it happens to be the hourglass, I have to get rid of the D6 and grab the hourglass. Now, there is another stipulation that I'm going to be leaving down here in the comments or in the information box, outlining the restraints of the challenge, and that is that I also have to use the spacebar item at least once, and that includes the D6. So, if we find something and I don't like it, say if it's like, let's just say if it's like my reflection in the first item room, I hit the spacebar item and that turns in, I use the D6 and that turns into a spacebar item, I have to use that spacebar item that my reflection turns into. You'll understand it's not really all that complicated. It's not really a science lesson, but let's begin. And again, I am going to be doing a challenge run here, so who knows if we're going to get a win streak. I don't know, man. I just don't know. I am going to also continue to do these seeds. I'm going to continue to show you the seeds as well for these challenge runs, so you can play along if you would like to also be challenged. Here's your seed for today. It's going to be Yankee, Juliet, X-Ray, Lima, Six Foxtrot, Delta, Sierra. And again, this is the spacebar override challenge. So as soon as I see a spacebar item, I have to pick it up and use it. So this is the Book of Shadows, and I have not used the D6 yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to check inside the curse room first. Actually, you know what? Well, no, I'm going to, as soon as I touch this book of shadows, I have to take it. So I can plan accordingly here with just the first run here, the first reroll. I'm not going to reroll the book of shadows since it is a spacebar item. So I'm just not going to get a reroll, and that's fine. So we'll go ahead and give it the D6, and we have the book of shadows, which is an item that I enjoyed a lot in vanilla, not really so much in Rebirth, but hey, you never know, we might be able to make something interesting happen. Who knows if these are going to be a win, if this is going to be a winning episode, or a winning streak, or a losing streak. Probably going to be the latter of the two, I'm guessing. And again, we are on the Curse of the XL, which I'm not too much a big fan of course. Now, since there is another item room here, I may go back. Okay, yeah, so what I'm going to do, just so I can say I've used both of the spacebar items, I'm going to go use the D6 on the Headless Baby. And again, with the spacebar override challenge, I have to use the spacebar item, including the one that I start with. So we'll go ahead and use the D6, and we get Dead Onion. Hang on that. And again, I do appreciate everyone submitting their ideas for the challenge runs that we're going to be doing here. But the Book of Shadows is our pony in the proverbial set odd race here. Secret room is most likely guaranteed to be right north of this room. It's a little bit too obvious. And of course, Curse of the XL means that we have the potential of getting a deal with the devil on the first floor. Ugh. Now, yes, I do know someone else pointed out, oh, Zinvicta, you should do a, you have to take all pills to drop challenge. I don't really consider that a challenge, to be quite honest. I mean, if people want to see that, maybe, I would say. Really, it's going to be the haunt, huh? Well, I guess I really shouldn't be all that surprised. If we're going to fight the haunt on an XL floor, I guess it's better that we have him number one instead of number two. Anyway, but someone mentioned that, oh, you've got to take all the, you have to take every pill that drops. Let's not die here, Isaac. How's that sound? And I don't really consider that a challenge, because that's kind of like just a, I don't know, like anyone can do that. That's not really a challenge. Not to poo-poo the idea, it's just that to me, that doesn't really feel like a challenge, put it that way. I had to use the Book of Shadows there, because I was pretty sure I was going to get mollywhopped by this jerk. Now I literally can't see myself. That was pretty cool. I was trying to lay a bomb so the haunt would run into it, and he ended up, Isaac was somehow behind the haunt, and I couldn't move. And that'll be it. Magic 8 Ball, it's not really the greatest, but I mean, I'll use it. Gonna be pinned. I'm just gonna use the tower card right away. That would have been nice if it worked, but it didn't. It would have been nice, but it didn't work. That's all right. We have Toxic Onion, or Dead Onion, rather, so Pin is going to be more of a joke than he already usually is. That was one of those fast jumps that Pin does, man. Sometimes Pin gets a wild hair about him, and he just flies across the screen. We did not get a deal with the devil, unfortunately. We did get the screw, which is a tears up and shot speed up, which is nice for Dead Onion. Feels very weird leaving the D6 behind in favor of the Book of Shadows, I will say that. Unfortunately, we don't have any money. Maybe we can get lucky here and find like a dime or something. I'd really take anything. I mean, we're on a Curse of the XL. We did not get a deal with the devil. Surprise, surprise, says no one. Especially given the fact that I did take some red heart damage. And, all right, well, there's our next space bar item. It's going to be Bob's Rotten Head. So, goodbye, Book of Shadows. Hello, Bob's Rotten Head. I have a feeling some of these challenges are going to be more fun than others. This one doesn't seem like it would be too bad, but it comes down to the RNG of it all. Which I guess, in a way, that's what everything comes down to. It's just how trolly does the game feel like being. And as we were just talking about that aforementioned previously beforehand, before this one run, which I won't be mentioning again, we've seen how bad it can actually get. I swear that is the worst, by far, that is the worst run in Rebirth that I have ever seen. Ever seen or have been a part of. That is, bar none, the worst run of all time. And yeah, we're just going to go on down to the next floor. Now, I will say this. Seriously, another XL floor? All right, so the game is still feeling like it's troll-worthy, so there's that. Two XL floors in a row, huh? I will say this. If we get something crazy like Kamikaze and we only have like a half heart left, obviously I don't have to use it right then and there. But I do have to use it once. But that doesn't mean I have to use it immediately, let's put it that way. So I'm pretty excited about having another deal with the devil kind of down the tubes here. I'm only assuming that we're not going to get it. You never know. We might find like the goat head or something. I should also mention, talking about shop items for a second, for the Spacebar Override Challenge, I do have the freedom to pick which item I want. So, for example, if there was, like, say, let's say that there was, like, the blue candle and the portable slot in the shop. I don't have to buy both of them. I can buy which one I want. But if I buy that one, then I have to use that one until I find another Spacebar item. Then I have to use that one. That's how it goes. I feel like this would have been a lot better had we not gotten two XL floors back-to-back like that. Very clearly, the secret room is right there, but I don't care. Actually, no, it's not. Take that back. I still don't care, though. All right, we got a couple of the silkworms. Our damage, honestly, is not that bad. And Dead Onion's helping us, but again, we're kind of getting stifled here by the fact that we're getting XL floors over and over again. I've always said from the start that I do believe that Curse of the XL is the worst curse in the game, in my opinion. Potentially one of the most dangerous curses as well. Only because of the fact that you skip an item room and you get robbed of a deal with the devil. Now, a couple of other people did mention that they would like to see a non-deal with the devil run. So, like only deal with the angel runs. Someone said, like, the purest would be you don't pick up any items. That's not going to happen. A couple other people said, like, oh, we'll just make you play the Lost. Lost runs are not happening either. I am never playing the Lost again, ever. Ever. I'm done. I think it's a dumb character and it's a dumb idea for a game like this. So, and I've been very publicly opinionated about that. One of the few things that I am pretty opinionated about. I think that the Lost is not fun. These are designed to be challenging and fun. And the Lost is not what I would consider a fun time. I mean, maybe the Lost's girlfriend, maybe she considers the Lost a fun time every now and then, if he hasn't been drinking too much, or if, you know, he happens to have watched a funny movie or a Three Stooges marathon on a Friday evening. But outside of that, no one thinks that the Lost is fun, at least not me. That was a slam dunk. Thank you, Bob's Rotten Head. Now, again, this applies to only spacebar items. So if there's an item that drops that is not a spacebar item, I'm not obligated to take it. This only applies to spacebar items. So both of our item rooms are right here. Actually, I'm gonna do the smart thing and just do this. How about that? How about that? I wish I had Bob's Rotten Head off of cooldown though. Normally I would just get in the host's face here, but I don't want to lose this half soul heart if I don't have to. There we go. No. Because as soon as we get shielded tiers, that ruins our spectral tier-like shot from... Ugh, well... Oh, man. Alright, well, let me go ahead and use Bob's... brain. Did that... No, whatever. Anyway, I'm not going to take Shielded Tears because it ruins our Dead Onion mechanic. I am going to go to the Curse Room here. We do have Dead Sea Trolls, which I'm not really all that excited about having, to be honest. I have to use the spacebar items at least once. I'm hoping that this is like a Telepills or something. Not Telepills, but Teleport. And it was... Oh, it was the Pinking Shears. By the way, the Dead Sea Scrolls, for those of you who don't know what it does, is a spacebar item that does every... It will mimic the spacebar item in the game. Every spacebar item in the game. Probably wasn't worth the two bombs that we paid there, but that's okay. So I'd love to find our Shopperino. Again, this is an XL floor, so we will most likely not be getting a deal with the devil, especially after all the damage I've been taking lately. And, yep, I'm just going to sit there and watch that bullet fly right into my face. It's a pretty good strategy. It's got the element of surprise about it, that's for sure. No one would ever expect someone who is semi-educated to sit there and get shot in the face by anything that can be easily dodged. So we will get done with this one. I guess I'm just going to use the Dead Sea Scrolls as well. Not sure what that did. That might have done the Necronomicon effect. I mean, I kind of heard the effect. I don't know what that was. I'm not sure. Still looking for ye olde shop. I am going to use this now, just so I know where the heck I'm going. Okay, so I'm going to go head for the secret room and also head for the shop. Really, really fortunate that we have the Dead Onion tiers right now. That's a big part of this. By the way, I should also mention that I'm not obligated to use the spacebar item on every cooldown. I can use it whenever I see fit. There we go. Got another stone chest. Not a stone chest, but a steel chest. I'll use it now, and it was Tammy's head! Hey, that was pretty good. Didn't do a whole lot of damage, and I lost the soul heart, but hey, that was certainly a good idea. Thank you, Dead Sea Scrolls, for not being completely useless for once. I will absolutely take Rusted Key. Alright, so far, okay, I guess. Is the way I would just describe this here. The Steam Sail, which is a good pickup. I'll buy the Steam Sail, but I'm not going to worry about anything else in there. And this is where we lose our deal with the devil. Guaranteed, bar none, if we hadn't already lost it, we lose it here. So, no deal with the devil, which sucks on a multiple level degree factor of 10. Because not only are we not getting another deal with the devil, but we are also skipping another deal with the devil. So that's three deals with the devil that we've been robbed of in 12 minutes and 14 seconds. All right, so I might as well go in here. It's going to be Mega Fatty. And we got Tammy's head again from Dead Sea Scrolls. And And needless to say, we don't have the greatest of damage, but Mega Fatty is a pretty good indicator of where your damage is right now at this presently current time. And our damage is not great. I was hoping the Dead Sea Scrolls would have given us something like the Pinking Shears again. That would have been nice. Rarely does the Dead Sea Scrolls ever turn out to be something like that's actually pretty good to have. Which is the reason why no one takes it. But hey, that's also the reason why we're doing a challenge run here. I have to take every single spacebar item that I see and override the previous one with it and use it at least once. Wait till we get, like, Undefined or the Shovel or something. That's gonna be scary. So there goes the deal with the devil. Again, not that we really had a chance anyway. And we're just gonna kind of sit here and watch Mega Fatty do his thing. Blue Cap. It's a great item. We needed the tiers up for sure. And we have Gertie Sr. Thank you, Rusted Key. Rusted Key, by the way, is a trinket that gives keys a higher chance to spawn, I believe. Something like that. So Gertie Sr. is a good matchup for us here. We have almost a 0% chance of getting a deal with the devil. It's not quite zero. If we beat Gertie Sr. without taking any damage, it's still possible, but I'm not expecting one. I'm almost expecting a deal with the angel at this point, to be honest. If we do get one, which I, again, don't foresee happening. Gonna try to keep the faith, though, no pun intended. Total pun intended. Blue Cap certainly did help out with our somewhat meager damage problem. So we are going to be able to beat Gertie Sr. Again, we did somehow unbelievably get a deal with the devil. I will absolutely take the wire coat hanger, although our damage is still not that great. And speaking of which, we have the Razor Blade, the Shovel, and Ghost Baby. I'm going to say I don't have to take one of those, and here's why. Because I do have the option of... I have the option of not taking a spacebar item that I have to pay for. So this will also give us a higher chance of us getting a deal with the angel. Oh, and we got Unicorn Horn. Could have been worse. There's also a bedroom here, which I am highly interested in getting at. So we got another key. And it is a dirty bedroom, which means that there's not a crawl space underneath there. It's just going to be a passage to the next floor, which obviously we don't want. But hey, we didn't get a Curse of the XL this time around. That's pretty happy about that. I'm also pretty happy about taking more terrible damage. We rolled the Book of Shadows with the Dead Sea Scrolls, which is pretty nice. I probably should have done that earlier. That's all right. And can I hit that Blast Assist from here? I think I can if I give it the old wound up, the old run up right here. There we go. And we got the... That's the nail. That's a nail, because we got a soul heart out of that. So far, Dead Sea Scrolls is actually working out fairly well. Surprisingly so. Very surprisingly so. Alright, we got our soul heart back, and we get a troll bomb, which I'm pretty happy about. I think we ended up taking damage from the spike door rather than the troll bomb there. I'm going to edit the rules saying that if it is a space bar item in the deal with the devil, I don't have to take it, because if it is detrimental to the run possibly, or if I can get a better chance of getting a deal with the angel, then I will do that. But shop items are different because that doesn't cost me any life. And yeah, I'm just going to take a hit, so there goes that soul heart. And we got Yumheart that time around. Let's try that again. Alright. So we were able to kill one hand and severely wound the other two. There we go. Now, as long as we don't get Kamikaze, we'll be okay. Dead Sea Scrolls can use Kamikaze. I probably just jinxed myself. That's okay, because the game's been like a total jinx of the past couple of weeks now. Even though we just had a pretty decent winning streak, the way it ended was unceremoniously terrible. Or maybe it was ceremoniously terrible. It depends on, I guess, how you look at it. From the game's point of view, I'm pretty sure that the game had a good old rousing laugh. That was definitely the Necronomicon. Dead Sea Scrolls actually surprisingly doing pretty good, all things considered. Normally, I'm used to seeing it just do, like, the Anarchist Cookbook, the Teleport, that sort of thing. Dad's Key is one of them. Which, Dad's Key is arguably okay, but... Speaking of Dad's Key, I'd love to get Dad's Key right now. And holy water! Holy water, what an amazing item, said no one ever. This is a very long Necropolis 1. Either that or the two XL floors that just kind of made time seem like it's freezing. Oh man, I'm gonna go to the big room now and use Dead Sea Scrolls. Whoa, it was shoop de whoop. I'll take it. Oh, there goes our deal with the devil. Not that we had any chance of getting one anyway, but hopefully we get a deal with the angel. Yeah, that was the world's smartest damage right there. Completely 100% avoidable damage that I walked right over. Pretty happy about that. I am going to take the blue candle here because it's far vastly superior to Dead Sea Scrolls. I'm also going to buy this soul heart, but not before we are ready to go to the boss. I don't know where the boss is right now. Should also probably buy a bomb, maybe get a black heart. So now I'm feeling a little bit better. Now that we have an actual good spacebar item, I'm feeling okay. It's not a one run by any means, but... You gonna leap, buddy? There you go. It's certainly no one run, but... Again, I feel a lot better now that we don't have to worry about the Dead Sea Scrolls. Hopefully, I will have a long, storied... perfect relationship with Blue Candle that it won't be overridden anytime soon. How come both of you are... There you go. I don't have any bombs, so unfortunately I will not be able to do that. Thank you, Blue Candidoo. And you know what? I'm probably prone to losing that heart anyway. Oh. Black Mask of Infamy. So no, I don't feel confident about our chances anymore of getting a deal with the angel. The only thing good about Black Mask of Infamy is that the heart does not shoot. But he moves, like, faster. Well, never mind. I take it back. I guess he does shoot. Yeah, and there it goes. So let's not die on Black Mask of Infamy. You could just back up off me real quick. I'd appreciate that. You're in my safety bubble there, Mask of Infamy. If I could kill you to where you would never show up again ever, I would. Like, I would kill you just so Ed wouldn't be able to put you back in the game again. I would. In a heartbeat, I would. Luckily, Dead Onion pretty much directly counters Mask of Infamy, and we get Cat Nine Tails, which is a fantastic item. So we're doing okay. Curse the Maze. It's better than not having, or it's better than having, like, Curse the Blind or Curse the Unknown. Cat of Nine Tails is a fantastic item, and that was also fantastic damage that I took there. And yeah, let's just keep on taking it. If we could get a bomb, that would be nice. I I would also, I wouldn't argue against having a little bit more movement speed either. Troll Bomb didn't really work out for us. We got double champion shove. This is going to be interesting with our movement speed. Luckily, this room does not have the usual spikes in it, so, and the blue candle should be able to dominate at least one of the chubs. All right, so here's our shop. And it's probably going to be greed, but this is the last good shot that we're going to have, so surprisingly, it's not greed. Starter deck and the sharp plug. I'll definitely take the starter deck. So we can get extra tarot cards, and we got the magician. Still don't know where our item room is. We found Mom. I cannot believe that that gluttony mob lived through that. See, even the blue flame destroyed the... How does that work, game? How does the blue flame destroy a champion gluttony mob, but the one that was over here wasn't killed? I don't know about that one, game. So, we're down to one heart, and we are in a lot of trouble here. I have to use bombs in this room, just to give us a chance at even getting, like, a decent tarot card would be nice here. Empress is decent, but not what we're looking for. I'll keep the Hangman and the Empress, just for utility reasons. Could use Hangman there, but not going to. Burnt Penny. Sure, I guess. Burnt Penny is a trinket that gives you it has a chance to spawn a bomb every time you pick up a coin. Let's see what our iron room. Oh, man. Well. Needless to say, it's going to be difficult to use this item more than once. In fact, I'm going to cheese it right now. There you go. Oh, no, we can't use magic fingers. Oh, woe is me. We don't have any bombs, unfortunately. Our item rooms have, needless to say, not been all that great for... Even if we weren't doing the spacebar override challenge, we would still be in rough shape right now. High Priestess is debatably better than Hangman, maybe. I mean, would it kill you just to give us one red heart? Thank you. I basically have to go in the curse room here, and yeah, we don't have any. We don't have any bombs, so if I were to try the thread the needle approach there, I probably would die. So I got one bomb. I could go back in the curse room, which is kind of a Hail Mary play, but at this point we need to find something. Because our damage is not good anymore. Not that it was, like, ever amazing to begin with, but now, especially on Necropolis 2, going into the womb, our damage is just awful. And there's an arcade over here, which, ironically, hilariously enough, we won't have access to. Because we don't have a coin. Yeah, this room is quite ridiculous, I will say that. You guys can just stop doing that. I'd appreciate it. One of the champions could actually kill us here, by the way. And we got a key. Thank you, Curse the Maze. Hey, Curse the Maze, if you could just F him. Never show up, I'd appreciate it. Yeah, and again, Curse the Maze. Never show your face here again. I think there was a red heart in the shop. And yeah, let's just keep on going with that, Curse the Maze. Appreciate that. There's not a red heart, but it's a soul heart. Alright, so we got enough money. That's super. Thanks for that. Alright, so since I have to use Magic Fingers once, I'm gonna buy the Soul Heart. I really want to go into the Curse Room. I really do want to go into the Curse Room. I have a feeling that's a lesson in futility, but at this point, we've got to go for something Hail Mary-ish. I'm going to use the Hangman card to get inside of the Curse Room, so we only take a half heart of damage whenever we exit. And hope that one of those blue fires in there drops at least one soul heart. Yeah, hey, Curse of the Maze, if I'd appreciate if you just leave the game now. So let's see how badly we get screwed in the Curse Room. Let's see, World card and the other one's Magician card. Alright, so we're gonna hopefully get at least one soul heart up here, and we did. And we got a Jira rune and a Hermit card, which could be pretty good. I'd love to keep the World card, but I also want to keep these soul hearts alive, and obviously I want to keep the Jira rune. So I am going to do that. So we have Jira and High Priestess. Where did my Empress card go, actually? I'd rather have the Whore of Babylon card for the mom fight than the High Priestess. The High Priestess card is just going to end up injuring me. That's a Magician card. Is it... I don't think we left it inside of the Curse Room, did we? I'm not going in the Curse Room to get it. Unless, of course, Curse of the Maze takes me in there, which in that case, I have no choice. Oh, yeah. Well, screw it, whatever. I've stopped caring. So, with this little precarious predicament we find ourselves in, I will use Magic Fingers on the mom fight when she spawns adds. And then, hopefully, we get a better spacebar item in the near future. Yeah, thank you, Curse of the Maze. Really happy that you're still here. Did decent damage. So this Jira rune is going to be pretty useful in the chest, if we make it there. I'm honestly not expecting to get into the chest here. Would be nice, but I am going to hold on to it. Unless we find a bunch of soul hearts or something, then I may use it on. I may use it in that room. Just keep the dream alive here. But not getting any deals with the devil. I mean, we had a chance to, but even if I had taken the shovel or the razor blade, we still would not have gotten anything else because we took way too much damage. The other floors. Obviously, having the start of two XL floors back to back is quite awful. And we get Curse of Loss, so shout out to RNG for that. Yeah, this is a fantastic room. Thank you, Polaroid, at least. I'll be shocked if we get to Isaac. If we get past Mom's Heart, I'll be thoroughly impressed. Let's put it that way. Really wish I had the blue candle right now, not gonna lie. Blue candle would have been pretty nice for a lot of these rooms. But hey, never say this. Invicta is not a man of his word. This is the challenge, man. There's nothing I can do. I can't talk my way out of it. It would literally be suicide for us to go inside of the Curse Room, so I cannot go in the Curse Room here unless I find more soul hearts. And even if we find two of them, I'm probably not going to go in there anyway. Yeah, and let's just not die to Isaac. How about that? So we're down to one half heart now. And we've got Black Husk. Actually, no, this is not the Champion Husk. This regular Husk. Who didn't drop anything. That is a big surprise. If we could get just one red heart or more, I'd be happy with that. But right now, not looking too good. And yeah, so that was the spacebar override challenge. I hope you all enjoyed that one. And again, please continue to send in your requests for other challenges. I'm not obligated to do all of them, but I will keep the more interesting ones on the side here. But thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time for more Isaac Victa. So long, everybody.